Okay, so welcome everyone for this edition of the BRAG, Brazilian Algebraic Geometry Seminar. I will ask you to kindly mute your microphone, except if you are the speaker. And we are recording this this talk, so if you do not want to appear in the video, please turn off your camera as well. And it is my great pleasure to introduce our speaker today, Josué Muratore from Universidade Federal de Minas Gerais, UFMG, and he will speak on enumeration of rational contact curves via torus actions. Please, Josué.
I thank the organizer for the invitation. So today we are going to talk about rational contact curves and the enumeration of them. Right. This is the plan of the talk. First, we give some quick generality, so definition example on contact structure and contact curves. Then we'll see briefly the moduli space of maps and how it is related with contact curves. And finally, we will compute some explicitly some enumerative invariant of contact curves. Let X be a complex manifold of odd dimension. A contact structure is on X is a line subbundle of the canonical vector bundle of X, such that if S is a non-trivial local section of L, then we have this condition, this wedge product is everywhere non-zero. By line subbundle, I mean a subbundle such that the quotient is again a vector bundle. Okay. For example, take any symplectic form on this vector space. It's classical that it induces in a natural way a subbundle of this type. All contact structure in the projective space can be constructed in this way, and they are equivalent by a change of coordinate. I mean that every line bundle on the projective space that gives a contact structure is O minus two, and this embedding is induced by a symplectic form on this vector space. Here, this P is the space of line of this vector space. The contact curves are exactly those curves embedded in X, such that the restriction of any local section of L is zero. Contact curves are very important when we study contact structure, important broadly speaking. What we are interested in here is the enumeration in the case of the projective space. So our goal is to compute the number of rational contact curves in any projective space with arbitrary incident conditions. So we, as a project, as a contact the projective space, we always can think about P3, but the definition are the same for the projective space. So a contact structure can be also defined by the association for each point of the projective space of an hyperplane containing the point. And the contact curves are exactly those curves C, such that the tangent band, the tangent space, the curves at the point is contained in the tangent space of H at that point. What I mean geometrically. Okay, we have this homemade curve in P3. As I said, for each point of space, we have a unique hyperplane passing through this point, and this hyperplane is given by the contact structure. And I claim that this red curve is contact because for each point, we have the unique plane and the curve is tangent to that plane. Here we have three points, so three spaces, three hyperplanes, and the curve is tangent to all of them. But this is a point-to-point condition. So for each point, we have the plane and the Coulomb's tangent to that plane. A very important remark that it holds in all contact structure is that the contact structure induces in this tangent space, this vector space, which is of even dimension, a simplistic form. And the tangent space of the curves is isotropic subspace. Okay, these are the main results of our work. We will find an appropriate moduli space containing all contact curves in the projected space. We will find an appropriate Gromov-Witten invariant related to enumerative numbers of contact curves. And finally, we compute explicitly some of this Gromov-Witten invariant using the torus section. Okay. Most of people here are familiar with the space M-bar more than myself, but I think it's useful for everybody to pick recall the definition. So we denote by M-bar 0M PND the moduli space of rational stable maps to PN of degree D and N marks. That is the moduli space of maps mu from C to PN such that D is a reduced connective projective one-dimensional scheme with the most nodal point and of genus zero. C has M marked points, which are regular. The push forward of the fundamental class of C is a one cycle of degree D. And if E is any reducible component of C that is contracted by mu, then E contains at least 3 points among the marks and intersection point with other components. Finally, we claim that two stable maps, which we denote by this set domain map and the market point. Okay, so two stable maps are equivalent if there exists an isomorphism which preserves the structure. So it computes with the map and it sends each market point to the other marker point with the same index. Okay, geometrically, we have to think about this moduli space of the moduli space of maps like this. We have maps with irreducible domain, so this this is a P1. We have maps with reducible domain, but without the contract component. So we have two component mapped curves. And we have a more complicated domains with eventually some contracted component. Finally, the property we will use are the following. The space has M maps, one for each market point, which we call evaluation map, and they are defined like this. Okay. Moreover, there is a, this is important, there is a dense open subscheme, which we call M without the bar, which parameterizes stable maps with a reducible domain. So this one, this of the first kind. And finally, there is a map which forgets the last mark between M bar with M plus one marks and M bar with M marks. Okay, let's go back to contact curves. Let's see the simplest case, the case of lines. So, given a symplectic form in this vector space, the space parameterizing two-dimensional isotropic subspace is classically denoted by SG. And it's not difficult to see that this is a linear section with the Plucker embedding of the usual Grammanian of lines. And so, the space SG. We see that the parameterized contact lines in the projective space. So this is the first moduli space of contact curves. As the classical SG is the moduli space of contact lines. And since it's given by a linear section of the Plucker embedding, the enumerativity of contact lines is already solved because the cycle of SG inside the Chow ring of the Grassmannian. It's the same of the Chow of the cycles of lines meeting a general codimension to linear subspace. So that, for example, what do we have in between? We have three general lines. And we know that for these three lines, we have a one-dimensional family of lines meeting all of them. We ask for the contact lines that meets all of them. So we can say that we are the intersection of this the number of contact lines which meets these three lines. We know that the SG has the cycle equal to the lines meeting a codimension two subspace. So to find the lines, the contact lines here, is the same to find the lines which meets a hypothetical fourth general lines. And we know that there are two lines meeting four general lines. So finally, we have that there are exactly two contact lines meeting three general lines. Let's see the contact conics meeting five lines. Okay, here we still didn't speak about a moduli space for contact conics, but we can say something. As before, take five general lines. We take three of them, and we see before that there are two contact lines through them. So take one now. Take one of the contact lines, and the other two general lines, and we see again that there are two contact lines meeting the first line and the other two. The same holds for the other contact lines. So if we consider the connected union of lines, we have contact conics that are reducible, which meets the five lines. So at the end, we got four of these contact conics. Now we should, okay, we can get more by changing the combinatorics. We can take these three as first and do the same. So now we should consider irreducible contact conics, but it can be proved that we don't have irreducible contact conics. This is has been proved in many ways. But what I want to point out here is that whenever is the general position of these lines, we always have reducible contact conics meeting all of them. And the reason of this fact will be explained soon. Okay. Now we need to change our point of view because we talked about embedded contact curves, but now we need to talk about stable maps, which is something different. So we need to introduce this definition. Okay, a contact morphism is a morphism such that the pullback of every local section of the contact line bundle is zero. Note that when mu is an embedding, this is exactly the definition of stable of contact curves. And a contact stable map is a stable map, C mu P1 Pm, such that mu is a contact morphism for some against any representative of the stable map. Okay, what I want to say here is that we know that we consider the stable map modulo automorphism of the domain. But to compose mu with an automorphism of C doesn't change this condition. So the definition of contact stable map is well posed. It doesn't depend on the representative of the moduli point. Okay, now we have this theorem that is already known for experts. So we'll give just a brief proof. It says the following. Consider the forgetful map between these two embars. The model space of context table maps, which I call by SMB, maps of the greedy with a mark and with the greedy and marks, is a zero section of this vector bundle. That is a vector bundle of rank 2D minus 1. This vector bundle is constructed in this way. We take the contact line bundle on the projective space. We take the dual, then we take the pullback with the last evaluation map. And then so with the canonical shift of P, and we push forward. I repeat here the theorem. As I said, the proof, this theorem is already known for experts. For example, Ye, in his Invenciones article, proved this a version of this theorem where the moduli space is the Hilbert scheme, of course. Lefkowitz and Weissacher considered the case where M is zero, but their proof works without any problem for every M. And we will see briefly how it works. It can be seen that the contact condition is equivalent to the condition that the map, the derivative of mu from C to the projective space, factors through this kernel. Okay, this is the kernel of this surjection. This surjection we know that L is embedded in, by definition of contact structure, in the canonical vector bundle. So if we take the dual of this embedding, we get this surjection. So we take the kernel, and the contact condition is equivalent that this map factors through this kernel. So we can consider the composition of these two maps, and by definition of kernel, this map must be zero, vanished at every point of C. So the contact stable maps are exactly the stable maps such that this map vanishes. And this is equivalent to say that this map is zero from OC to this if, and by general scheme machinery, the locus of the curves where this map is zero is exactly given by a section of this vector bundle. Note that marked points and contracted components play no role. It means the following. Suppose that you have a contextable map, for example, embedded, and you add to the domain some contracted component or some marked point. Okay. This doesn't change the contact structure, the contact property. So our stable map is still contact, even if we add an arbitrary number of contracted component. Okay. Now we have this theorem that is important for our goal. It says the following. Okay, SMB is the moduli space of context table map, and it's given by the zero section of a vector bundle. So it has an expected dimension that is different between the dimension of M bar and the rank of the vector bundle. Here we prove that this space is exactly of the expected dimension. So we don't have excess intersection, and this is very important for enumerative parts. We see just a sketch of the proof. Okay, first of all, note that this lemma, so that this space is exactly of the expected dimension, is proved already when we don't have a marked point. If it's proved in the case with M equal to zero, then it's proved in any case with a fixed D. This is because of what I said before, that market point play no role. So if we consider more market point, we don't change the contact structure, so everything goes well. Now we can argue by induction on D. Okay, the case D equal to 1 and 0 market points, so the case of lines is SG, which is a classical space that we know very well. So this case I already know. Now we have to distinguish two cases. First, we consider the case where the context table map have irreducible domain. Remember that this is the open set, the open subscheme where of stable map with irreducible domain. Okay, this has expected dimension, and I use a result of 98. Here they study the moduli space of contact morphism from P1 to the projective space. This is much simpler than our situation because here, so from morphism from P1 to the projective space, you can consider the polynomial much simpler. Not that we take a quotient of that space because we consider a stable map. So we take contact morphism modulo automorphism of P1. So this is a bit different. But anyway, you can use that result, and we prove that in this case, this open set of SMD has the expected dimension. Okay, now we have to study a reducible case. So the complement of this space is a UNOF boundary divisor that are constructed of this type, a Cartesian diagram of this type, where D1 and D2 are positive integer strictly less than D, where the sum, their sum is exactly D. Okay, the contact stable maps contained here are maps where each component is contact. So the space of contact stable maps contained here is exactly this space. But here, D1 and D2 are strictly less than D. So we can use induction, and we can compute explicitly the dimension of this space. And this happens to be exactly the same dimension of all the space. This is a bit difficult, but it's quite surprising. What I want to say is the following. Okay, inside the SMD, we have a contact stable map with a reducible domain, with a domain made by the gluing of two curves, or we can have a more component. The field space can be defined this way. So it's all S0D intersected with this open set. So this curve like this are parameterized by this space. The second space is, this is irreducible, and we glue with another irreducible. And this space is, a curve like this are parameterized by this. And generally we can have a more component, and all of them are containing the same bit. So the total degree is D. What we said before is that all of these spaces which are containing SMD have the same dimension. So SMD is a moduli space where a boundary have the same dimension, has the same dimension of all the space. This was quite surprising, and this is the reason why we always have in our computation a contribution from reducible proof. Okay, let's pass to enumerative application. Consider gamma 1, gamma n, B subvariety of this projective space. And we have this condition on the dimension. If we apply the Clement-Bertini theorem to this diagram, we deduce that the number of contact curves meeting general translate of gamma 1, gamma n is the degree of the zero of this zero cycle. Okay, what I want to say here is the following. By Evi-Childa, I mean the evaluation map on all m bar restricted to SMB. The Clement-Bertini theorem, among many things, say the following. Okay. B, this projective space as a transitive action by invertible matrices. You can take a general matrix and you can translate this gamma one. You can translate all the gamma one, gamma two, gamma m, and you can translate by different matrices for each one. So you translate them by some general matrix in such a way that these cycles, this zero cycle, it's a zero cycle for this condition. This zero cycle is a zero cycle supported in a reducible scheme. So it has an enumeratory meaning because the scheme is reduced. Here we use it that SMD has exactly the expected dimension. There is no excess. Okay, we know that SMD is given by the zero cycle, the zero locus of a section of a vector bundle. So the push forward to M bar is the top Chern class of that vector bundle. So finally, we deduce the following corollary, corollary of the Clement-Bertini, I would say. So consider gamma 1, gamma m, this a variety of the projective space in general position with this condition of on the dimension. Then the number of contact curves, not stable maps, contact curves in P, in the projective space of degree D and meeting all this gamma is exactly this integral. We use the projection formula to pass from this integral to this, from this integral to this integral. So we found what he was looking for. This is exactly a way to find the number of contact curves. Such a computation includes reducible contact curves. What I mean is the following. As I said before, SMD is a union of these spaces for each for each behavior of the course. We have a reducible, we have a reducible, irreducible, we have a reducible with certain degree, we have a reducible with more component. So in this diagram here, we have a union of spaces, all of the same dimension. So all of them have a non-trivial contribution in this zero cycle. So for these reasons, this is not the number of irreducible contact curves. It's the number of contact curves for every behavior of the domain. Okay, I just ended the second part of the talk, and now I'm going to start the third, the last part. So if there is some question on up to this part, I can answer. If not, I can go. So there is some question. So if there are no questions, I can follow. Okay, now we want to compute explicitly some of these values. And we are going to use the Kosevich-Diabot formula. So consider T, torus, G star n plus one times, which act on Pn in this way. This is what I call the standard action. Okay, and here we have n plus one fixed point, which are Q0, 1, 0, 0, 0, Q1, 0, 1, 0, 0, and so on. And we have coordinate lines, which are lines through to fixed point. And we have this number of lines. Okay, if I have a stable maps, and I compose with some element of T by acting on Pn. I get another stable map. So by a natural composition, the action of the torus lift to M bar. And the fixed locus of the action is the locus of maps, whose image is the connected union of one or more coordinate lines. And there is a bijective correspondence between graph with some combinatorial property and fixed logic. And we denote by GDD the set of such a graph. Okay, what I mean here. Suppose that this cube is P3, and these are the fixed point of the action. So this is 1, 0, 0, 0. This is 0, 1, 0, 0, and so on. A stable map is a map where, for example, this component is mapped to this line, and these other two components are mapped to this line. The map can be not injective in general, and when it is not injective, the position of the ramification locus give us another different stable map. So we have connected components of stable maps, and a very useful way to parameterize the connected component here of fixed logic is through graph. Okay, let's see some example, because this part is very briefly explained because it's a bit complicated, but I hope that the idea is clear. Let's see some example in the case without market point. For D1, the graph which I was talking about are the following. A graph and a single edge. In the case of D equal to one, we have a single edge, and this edge means line from lines through Qi and Qj, where Qi and Qj are two fixed points. One means that the map is injective. For D equal to two, the graphs are the following. By Qi, Qj, and Qk, we mean three different fixed points in between. And here, this means line through Qi and Qj, and plus line from Qj and Qk. So it's a stable map with two components that are mapped to these lines. Here it's the same, where Qk is the same of Qi. And finally, we have this map. This means a map from a domain with an irreducible domain that is mapped 2 to 1 to this coordinate line. So anyway, fixed maps are this way, and the fixed logic, so it means the connected component, are parameterized by this type of graph. Okay, this is the Concevich-Atiyah-Bott formula. So consider V to be an equivariant vector band. Equivariant means that it's some behavior with the action, but all our bundles are equivalent, so it doesn't matter the definition. So let V be an equivariant vector bundle on this M bar. Let PDV be an arbitrary polynomial in the term class of V. The Concevich-Atiyah-Bott formula is the following. Suppose that this is a zero cycle. This is the sum of all the graph lambda of this quotient, where PDT is the corresponding equivariant polynomial of PV, restricted to the fixed locus parameterized by lambda. A lambda is an integer, it depends on the automorphism of lambda, and n lambda is the normal bundle of m lambda inside n bar. So very, very roughly speaking, this formula permits to compute an arbitrary integral of this type in terms of the behavior of B on the fixed locus of the action on M bar. Such a sum is a usually very large sum of rational polynomial, because each one of these quotient is a rational polynomial in this field. So we have a sum of rational polynomial, but when we started to do the algebraic simplification, at the end, all these terms magically disappears and we got an integer number. Okay, let's see an example of this formula. Let's take the case of lines in between and let zeta to be the subspace parametrizing lines meeting a general point. Okay, I proved in my article, but I think it was very already known that this can be written as a polynomial P of term classes of equivalent vector boundary. Okay, when lambda is this graph, which I recall this is the only graph in the case of lines. Okay, when lambda is this graph, we have that this PT gamma is this polynomial. Okay, suppose that we want to compute the number of lines in P3 meeting two general points, and we want to use the conservative formula. So we have to compute this integral. This is the number of lines through 2 points. Okay, this is this sum by the Concevich Atiyah Bot formula. PT lambda is no. We square because we are considering meeting, we have taken the square because it's 2 points, general point. Expression of the top term class of n lambda is computed by Concevich and it is this product. At the very end, we have this sum between I and j from 0 to 3 of this expression. Now, if you write explicitly all this expression and you start doing simplification, at the end you get 1. So this is something very surprising, but it always works. It's always true. So, okay, now we want to apply this machinery to our case. This is the integral which gives the contact stable maps, contact curves. By projection formula, we can reduce it to another computation in a different modulus space. We get rid of M, now is 0, and we have this integral. Okay, we can combine the result of Amorim, which is the first who studied the contact curves through this point of view, through M-bar, myself, to apply the Concevich-Atiyah-Bot formula and compute explicitly the intersection for arbitrary incidence conditions. So what I mean is that this part is a polynomial in Chern, in a Chern class of equivariant vector band. And we can find explicitly a restriction to every m lambda, I mean, attend the all the Concevich-Atiyah-Bot formula for arbitrary n, t, gamma and lambda. So let's see an example. So we have this proposition. So if lambda is this graph, the equivariant class of the top Chern class of this vector bundle restricted to M lambda is this polynomial. So we have we pass from Chern class to polynomials. And moreover, when lambda is the union of two subgraphs that meet at a vertex V, we have this other equation, and this basically resolves all the graph. We are able through this two format to compute all the graph. The first who proved this proposition was Amorim. I found a different proof, and I also find a proof to write all this expression for arbitrary gamma as a polynomial in general class of vector bundle. Here I give some example of who is this polynomial in some of the graph. In this graph is this, in the other graph is this. It's just an application of the question we just saw. So when we compute this this integral, we have to deal with the polynomial like this. But at the end, they are also they are integers. So I used a computer clearly, and I found the number of contact curves in the in P3. So the number of contact curves of degree D in P3 meeting A general lines and B general points are given by the following table. Some of the value of this table, like this, where was already found by Lefkowitz and Ben Secher. This was found by Amorim. The other one was not known, but with Xaba Schneider, we are writing a code to perform a computation in the Concevich-Yabot formula for arbitrary computation, not only contact rules. So when this this code will be ready, we will have much more terms in each table for D1, 4, 5, 6, 7, and so on. And the drawback of the Concevich-Yabot formula is that, as you saw, it involves a lot of tedious computations, and also it covers some structure of the numbers. So it's a exactly one one answer each time, but we don't know nothing about theoretically. Some formula involving the structure of this number. This number may have some structure, and my research is to find if there is some structure of this invariants. The last things I want to say is that focus on this one. This is the number of contact cubics through one general line and three general points. Okay, and the formulas say that we have 12 of them. So one may be interested in found how many irreducible we have, a reducible curve we have of this type. So suppose this is our general line and three general point. One reducible curves, so a union of contact lines, may be the following. This is a contact cubics meeting these subschemes. And it's not hard to see that we have exactly 9 curves of this type. But since the total is 12, if we want a reducible one, I mean, of this type, this means that we have to subtract from 12 the reducible one. The reducible one are 9, so we have 3 irreducible contact cubics meeting this, these 3 points and this line. And okay, so one may be interested to find which of these are irreducible, and it's a combinatorial problem that may be left for some other project. So these are the some of the article I used, and I just finished. Thank you.
Thank you, Josué.
Okay.
me stop recording.